With us in the studio for the first time, historical on Head Start, and I hope this is the first of many more to come. Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago is with us. Welcome to Hot Copy. Thank you for coming, Senator Miriam.
Karen, your program, which is very popular all over the archipelago, is entitled Head Start.
Yes.
But when I'm your guest, it should be entitled Head Butt.
Headbutt, you're extreme hot cop. You know, before we start the interview, I know you wanted to say something
right.
for the new year.
That's right.
Okay.
I am quoting from a very famous female poet in England. She's not very famous here in the Philippines.
Okay.
But this was her message that was read by one of the modern English kings during his annual New Year's Day broadcast. It goes like this. It is not a poem. It's sort of a narration. I asked the man who stood at the gate of the new year, "Lend me your lamp so that I can see my way." The man said, "No, but put your hand in the hand of God. That will be safer than a light and will protect you in every way."
That is so beautiful.
That's right.
My gosh, that's a very beautiful poem.
Right.
Do you compare that? Is there a parallelism with what you believe?
Oh, yes, absolutely.
Okay.
You know, we are just humans. We're one of many life forms in the universe. We don't even know what is our relationship to other life forms on other planets, whether we are retarded or advanced. Or
okay.
But still, you have to sort it out for yourself that it can't be possible that we exist only for ourselves or that we are confined only to the material demands of our planet. There must be a higher intelligence. Maybe it started the Big Bang, and that's how the universe came into being. Plus, we must remember, there is now not only one universe, but many universes. There are multiverses now, according to our astronomy, and we don't even know whether that is advanced or primitive astronomy. So we have to contend with factors other than ourselves, higher than ourselves. And that is what some people call God.
Okay. Now, the problem, some people say, is you're way too intelligent. And you have Senate President Enrile, who's also way too intelligent. And then both of you seem to have this nonstop headbutting.
Right.
Yes, that just, I don't even know what the cause is. Do you know when it started?
Oh, yeah. During the time of President Cory Aquino,
okay.
He was very resentful that I had been his subordinate and who had invited him to one of my principal sponsors at my wedding, where he did not show up.
He didn't show up?
It was Senator at that time, Ninoy Aquino, who was personally present.
Okay.
Anyway, well, during the time President Cory Aquino, Enrile was very jealous of President Cory because he thought that after Marcos, he should take over. Remember, he was the administrator of the Martial Law Administration for 20 years.
Okay.
It's very difficult to leave power. So when President Cory came in, he was very jealous and envious that, you know, an ordinary housewife with no background, with no significant undergraduate degree should take over. And then he heard that I had accepted the position under President Cory. The first position was Immigration Commissioner,
yeah.
For which I won the Magsaysay Award for Government Service.
Yeah.
But that didn't stop Enrile from telling people who got back to me that I was corrupt. But
yes.
I had already been vetted or screened by the members of the Magsaysay Awards Foundation without my knowledge. So that is my main claim to fame. Galit siya dahil sa tingin niya, iniwan ko siya. He's very, very possessive.
Because you had worked with him. He said when he was Justice Secretary, he hired you.
No, he didn't.
Oh, he did not?
No.
He said that on this show.
No, he didn't hire me. I was invited to work there by Undersecretary Efren Plana. And I think there were some other people ahead
yeah.
of him.
Or okay. And he had said he called your attention on using either, was it a smuggled car or a custom seized car?
No, he never did that. That occurred afterwards during the commission appointments hearing on my appointment as Agrarian Reform Secretary. Maybe he's suffering from old age dementia because he's 89 years old. I'm saying this with a straight face because my mother is 90 years old.
But his memory is very sharp.
Well, so is my mother. My mother was a genius in mathematics.
Okay.
But, you know, sometimes she confuses her timelines. And I have talk to doctors. I have offered to bring my mother to them. They say, don't be worried, because that is really part of old age. So, you know, you make slips of fact and you invent little fictions to yourself. I always tell my mother on the telephone, be careful, mom, watch out. You might be suffering from dementia, old age dementia, which is perfectly natural for a person your age. Sometimes it leads to Alzheimer's.
Okay, all right. Now, okay. Okay,
gotcha.
Gotcha. Now, I wanna ask you this. After Senate President Enrile's conduct in disbursing the Senate savings, my first question before we go on, because you've spoken lengthily about this everywhere, do you believe he should not be, or he should no longer be, the Senate President come 2013?
He should never have been Senate President. He's charging that I'm always absent because I'm always sick. First, I had hypothyroidism.
Yes, okay, yeah. I had thyroid.
Yeah.
So I know. Okay. It's hypo or hyper?
I had hypo.
Okay.
So I had no energy and I had to see a doctor for a long period of time because I couldn't even get out of bed.
Yeah, yeah.
And then I had high blood pressure, which was very evident during the impeachment trial. And it was not my own doctor, but the doctors and nurses of the Senate that always took my blood pressure when I felt ill. That's why sometimes there are pictures of me leaning back on my chair. I'm not being relaxed.
Okay.
I'm trying to rest my nape.
Okay.
And now he has the gall to accuse me of ill health. Is it a crime to be sick? That is in effect what he is saying. What about him? When he calls the Senate to order, then he descends very slowly with the help of other people, and then he calls on the Senate President pro tem to conduct sessions every afternoon. And he doesn't even sign finance documents or other documents, I believe.
So who signs them?
His chief of staff.
Is that right?
Well, you can delegate power to your chief of staff, but not to that extent, I think.
Okay, now quickly, you said he should have never been Senate President, but it seems to me that the Senate President, JPE, enjoys the support of the majority of the senators.
Only because one of his strongest supporters in the political universe insists that...
Who's that?
I'm not going to say.
Okay, can you say? Can you please say? Okay.
Call 8. Wild horses and you can drag it out of me, but otherwise I prefer to keep quiet about it because the other person might not want to be identified.
Okay.
I don't care myself.
Is it the president?
No.
Okay, all right.
Well, anyway, one of these political factions wants him there because in 2016 he'll be too old and too superannuated, too lacking in energy to run for president. And this faction does not want anyone in the position of Senate President who can possibly be a credible potential presidential candidate in 2016. That's why he's there. And then, remember, he doesn't belong to any major political party. He now belongs to the UNA coalition, which is a coalition of several political parties. Mm-hmm. He's a member of the PMP, Partido ni President Estrada.
So you could be referring to Erap or Binay?
Yes, of course.
Okay, all right. I mean, as a major supporter, the man behind him.
They are not his supporters. They are not his patrons.
Okay.
So he belongs to this group. I'm helping you to analyze how he came to power. It's because nobody wants to put anybody who might be a viable presidential candidate in 2016. So they settled on the oldest member of the Senate because by 2016, wala na siyang qualifications. He will knock himself out. He will disqualify himself by his old age.
Yeah, but I'm curious, he has accused you of trying to actually unseat him. Have you really been trying to unseat him?
Of course not. I cannot talk to Malacanang because I was against the impeachment of Chief Justice Corona that put me in the doghouse, even if technically.
Okay.
Yeah, so I am incommunicado. And then I have no party of my own except my own People's Reform Party. I always write that in my application for candidacy with the COMELEC.
Okay.
And I always run as guest candidate of some other party that will have me. Or sometimes I'm guest candidate of several political parties and I try and attend the rallies of each one in sequence. These last elections, I mostly campaigned with the party of Senator Manuel Villar.
Okay.
Because all expenses were covered by the party. So
okay.
We didn't
yes.
have to spend our own. So I don't, how can I possibly make any move? And he knows that I'm not the kind who will go around organizing political stratagems. I'm just too busy for that. I would rather just stare blankly into open space and contemplate my non-existence or my total annihilation after death.
Okay, all right. Okay, all right. Okay, now I want to ask you this because Senate President Enrile has been on this show a few times and he had mentioned, okay, that this is not the first time that you got additional, in other words, that you got maintenance and operating expenses in your Senate office. I put in graphics what his office sent me. Do we have that prepared? I asked. Okay, this is what they are claiming, that the 1.6 million is not new. They are saying, okay, for 2012, so this was 600,000 released to all senators, tranches 2 and 3. This is the controversial one, was 1.6, except to you, the Cayetanos, and Enrile. But go at years before that. Do you have that in graphics? The years before that? Okay. All right. The years before that, Senator Miriam, their office sent me a message and said in 2008, you received 1.5 million year end as MOOE. In 2009, it was roughly 1.3 M. In 2010, it also amounted roughly to 1.3 M. In 2011, it also amounted roughly to 1.3 to 1.8 M. All senators got the same.
That's right.
All senators. So he is saying, Senate President Enrile saying, Senator Miriam has been getting these cash gifts at the end of the year.
So my question is, why now have you excluded me? What is your basis? What are your legal criteria? Under the Equal Protection Clause, if people are similarly situated, you must treat them the same way. So what is the law that gives him the power to pick and choose where he will spend the money? But let me tell you this.
So this is your issue, no? It's the discretionary aspect.
Apart from that, let me tell you this. I was elected in 1995 as senator. My first year was 1995. At the end of 1995, I had savings in my office.
Okay.
I sent it back to the Senate Secretariat, expecting that it would go back to the National Treasury. But instead, apparently, it was distributed to the Senate Secretariat employees.
Okay.
And they thanked me for it. But if I had known that would happen, I would have given it to my own staff.
Yeah.
It's just that later on is when I realized that this was not equitable. But anyway, I let it go. Plus, apart from that, my fellow senators at that time in 1995 came down on me like a ton of bricks. I was criticized publicly.
For returning
the money. That very act alone made me a pariah among the senators in 1995.
Okay.
Because one said, she's just showing off at our expense. She's making us, another said, she's making us look bad. And another said many other negative things about me. Kaya kung ibalik mo pala ang pera sa gobyerno, masama pala yun dahil magagalit ang makasamahan mo. Dapat pala, manahimik ka na lang. All right. Next, I think the next year, or subsequently, after my first year in the Senate, the senators, I discovered during a caucus, agreed to give themselves additional pork barrel. I raised questions about what is our legal basis. We have legal basis for regular pork barrel, but what about this new additional pork barrel? So I refused to receive my own pork barrel. And then one major daily in our country published on the front page a list of all the senators except me.
Okay.
And showing how much they received an additional pork barrel. MDS, zero. So, hindi nila masabi na bakit hindi ka nagreklamo noon. Plus, remember, I've been a senator for now 2.5 terms. That's 6 years plus 6 years, that's 12, plus 1/2 so far.
Yeah.
So, that's already 15 years. I've been senator for 15 years. These senators who are not apparently acting as attack dogs of Enrile, kasi pareho kaming abogado, dapat magdebate kami sa publiko, ayaw niya. Pero pinapa-atake niya ako sa mga attack dogs niya na hindi man lang abogado. Nag-aabo-abogadohan. Yun ang problema kasi sa mga senador eh. Hindi nila alam ang batas. Tapos just because they're senators, they think they have immediate knowledge of the entire universe
okay.
of the legal system. Ngayon, maliban dyan.
No, but my question is, was it wrong for Enrile then to actually distribute these savings, given that it was done many years back and you yourself had received them?
Yeah, there was nothing wrong at the start. Para itong retirement bonus or pabaon sa armed forces, maliit lang yan noon. Pinatanong ko ng bago pa akong senador. Magkano ba yan? Plus, you must remember, kaya kung maliit na halaga, lumaki ng lumaki over the years. Plus, ngayon, 2 million na. Kasi hindi lang 1.6 million pinagatian niya. Pati bawat senador, merong 250,000. So, 1.6 million.
Roughly close to 2.
That's right. Uh-oh. So, sabihin na lang natin, 2 million na ngayong taon. Sa next year kaya, pwede kayang 2.5. The year after that, pwede kayang 3 million. In other words, I'm using argumentum ad absurdum. That's always how you argue in law.
Yeah.
You reach the most absurd conclusion because it is possible.
But is it the amount or is it the fact that the Senate president can choose to give it to his allies and not give it to... I mean, is that your issue?
Pareho.
Pareho.
Yeah. Hindi bali noon. Siguro when I was very young senator, basta I kept on making noises about these extra expenses from extra funding from the Senate. And at that time, MOOE was something like 200,000. Remember?
A year. Only at the end year, an additional.
Right. So, you know, I issued a directive to my finance director, who acts as my accountant and auditor, rolled into one. I said, we accept money provided it meets two criteria. Okay. Number one, it is given to all senators. Kasi, pag hindi mo tinanggap, magagalit pa lang kapwa senador mo. Pangalawa, it should be, there should be a requirement that it should be liquidated by means of vouchers or receipts.
So, is it liquidated?
Yes, we liquidate everything. So, over the years, I have not bothered to check what money came in because ang daming checking pupasok sa senador. Kaya nang tinanong ng pahayagan na nagbukas ng balita na ito, ang mga senador, hindi ba nila alam? Kasi they don't even know how much money comes in. Also, in my case, I have more things to do than check how many checks come into my office every month.
Okay.
I wouldn't know.
Now, Senate President Enrile had told me that when he gave you, Alan, Pia, and Trillanes, $250,000, I believe, that when you returned it, you had actually deposited the $250,000 in your personal account.
Not me. Not me. This was given during the holidays. And pursuant to my instructions to my staff, without my knowledge, remember, there were so many holidays in between and very few working days in between. So maybe my staff just got very concerned that they cannot leave a check for $250,000 lying around.
Yeah.
So they,
deposited it
immediately.
Okay.
Because it said personal cash gift. When I learned about it, just like most senators, hindi naman ako lang eh. Lahat kami.
Yeah.
Hindi maintindi kung magkanong pumapasok. Nalaman ko na linagyan daw palang cheque ng personal cash gift. Akako kung personal.
Kasi pera niya yun eh.
Oh,
daw yung $250,000.
Hindi niya pera yun. Savings yun ng opisina niya. We're talking of the people's money. Can I emphasize, please? We are talking of the money of the Filipino taxpayer. Nagramit daw na savings ng Senado as an agency and then savings of the office of the Senate President. But anumang savings yon, pera yan ng taong bayan. Pwede mo bang pamigay yan bilang regalo na 2 milyon bawat senador ng daming mga biktima ng kalamidad? Pagkatapos, bakit sila tanong sa akin? Ang tinatanong ko lang ay ganito. Makatarungan ba yung ginawa ninyo ng pera ng bayan? Pinamimigay nyo sa mga sarili ninyo sa kautusan ng Senate President para sa sarili ninyo na ang dami nating mga biktima ng bagyo, ng baha at iba pang mga kalamidad sa ating bansa? Matatanggap ba yan ng pangkaraniwan na taong bayan? Yan ang pagtatanong. Mm-hmm. Bakit ngayon ako ang
kini-question?
Yeah. You are forcing me to defend myself against all of these idiotic questions that are mainly sourced over your own ignorance, either of the law or of my personal history with the spending of people's money.
Now, paano to, ma'am? The Commission on Audit has sided with Enrile and said he has not done anything wrong. Malacanang, I think, in a press con, Ricky Carandang has said, the Senate has financial autonomy.
Ah. Kasi nag-aabugaduhan na naman itong mga ito. Yun ang problema eh.
And what about the COA?
Oh, ngayon, itanong ko lang sa kanila ganito. ang base natin ay ang saligang batas. Kung ano nung batas ang pinagsasite nyo. Lahat ng batas kailangan ayon sa Constitution o saligang batas. Ngayon, under Article 6, Section 25, paragraphs 5 and 6, we have the following provisions with respect to public funds.
Mm-mm.
There shall be no transfer of appropriations except the heads of the three branches of government and the heads of constitutional commissions.
Okay.
Yan, pwede mong i-transfer ang appropriations mo. Kaya kung may savings ka, pwede mong idagdag doon sa mga nasa budget mo na. Pero maliban dyan, anong savings ang pinag-usapan natin? That is the constitutional issue. Pwede ba napilitin mo na may savings ang opisina mo para mabigay mo sa sarili mo, sa mga kapwa mo, sa katapusan ng taon?
Lalo na magtitipid ka during the year.
That's
no?
Right. Okay. That is my point. Para sa Pasko, ibabigay mo sa sarili mo, sa mga kasamahan mo, para hindi na kayo mag-ingay lahat. Makatarungan ba yan? That is the basic question. Anong ibig sabihin ng savings? Kasi ang alam ko, naging racket na ito dahil ginagaya nilang Senado eh. Oo, mga opisina na hindi nabanggit doon sa saligang batas, ganun din sila. Ayaw nila gumastos para sa opisina. That's what I call forced savings. Para pag Pasko, gayahin nilang sinarot, pamigay nila sa sarili nila.
Yun nga nangyayari.
Makatarungan ba yan? So, answer me. That's with respect to paragraph 5. With respect to paragraph 6, nakalagay, discretionary funds shall be spent for public purposes. Anong ibig sabihin ng public purpose? Irigalo mo sa Senado ang 2 milyon, sa Senador ang 2 milyon. Anong public purpose yan? Gagawa yan ng sinungaling na papel. Sabihin niya, may public purpose ito. Pero ibubulsan niya yon. Let's be real. Let's get real, guys. Tanungin mo lang sa man in the street, sa tao sa daan. Makatarungan ba yan ng pera ng galing sa buwis na binabayad ng taong bayan ay ipamamahagi ng mga tataas na opisyal bilang Christmas gift nila sa isa't isa? Tama ba yon? At 1.6 million, 2 million na ngayon na pagkasunduan natin, 2 million na ngayon. Next year kaya, payag ba kayo kung 3 million pamigay sa bawat senador? The year after that, payag ba kayo kung 4 million, 5 million? When will this end? That is the question. So it's not only constitutional, it is also ethical and moral.
I'm curious, the almost 2 million given to the majority of the senators, do you believe that they would spend that for something personal?
Kasi tinawag yan na additional MOOE. MOOE ay shorthand yan for maintenance, operating, and other expenses.
Yeah. What is, so if I want to buy a new suit, kasama yan?
Well, that would be your other expenses, but you're not going to put it on paper. You can just put it as a representation expense.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm curious. Forgive me for asking this, but what did you do with your MOOE from 2008 to 2011 when you also received, it was pretty big then, ma'am. It was almost like 1.3 million at the end of each year.
I don't know if we received it at the end of the year.
Oh, I think in tranches.
Installments.
Yeah.
Ganito ang punto dyan. MOOE, alam mo yan, ilagay na natin sa layman's language, our office expenses.
Yeah.
Paggastos mo sa opisina.
Paano si Joker Arroyo walang office staff?
Ang ganito yan.
What does he do with this MOOE?
Yeah. Kasi, bawat buwan, ang bawat senador, binibigyan ng 2.2 million.
Every month?
Every month.
So you receive 2.2 M also, every month?
Right,
you.
Me.
Okay, your office.
My office.
Yeah, but your salary is something like 75,000. Okay, I know that. Yeah.
I get 2.2 million.
Every month.
I am required by the budget office to spend one half of that on personal services. Meaning to say, pang sweldo ko sa staff ko. Hindi nila kinakuha ang sweldo nila sa Senate.
Not sa Senate, sa office mo.
That's right.
Kinukuha, per senator.
That's right. Kaya, nasa sa senador yun kung ilang taong...
Yeah.
Ang susweldohan
niya. Kung maliit ka magsweldo o malaki ka magsweldo.
That's right. At saka ikaw mag-determine kung ano ang sweldo ng bawat isa.
Okay.
Ngayon, 2.2 million na yan, kalahati para sa sweldo.
Net to, yung 2.2, net na?
Net. Okay. 2.2.
All right.
Pagkatapos, ang kalahati niyan dapat gastusin mo sa rental mo sa opisina. Kung wala kang, kasi may mga opisina kami sa Senado, maliliit na mga kwarto yon, hindi kasya. For example, okay. In my case, I always have a staff maybe 30 to 40. Ngayon, kung meron kang natawag na satellite office, in addition, dagdag pa yon sa opisina mo sa Senado, binapayagan kang mag-upa.
Okay.
Some of us rent, but some of us don't.
So you rent?
I rent.
Okay.
Tapos, sa MOE na yan, bayaran mong renta mo, uh-oh, ang tubig, kuryente, office equipment mo.
Okay, yeah, supplies. But to get to the point, there was a senator, I won't mention his name, but in the past, was caught having ghost employees.
Oh, yun na nga. Kasi personal salaries eh. De, maraming avenues for corruption yung 2.2 million na yan.
Okay.
As you said, Karen, all you have to do is put names there and then pretend that you have paid their salaries, but it all goes to you. Or you can put also additional expenses from MOOE, but it all goes to you. No, you can just use any manner of words there. Ngayon, ang ating punto dito ay ganito. Bawat buwan, meron kang MOOE.
Yeah.
Oh, every year yan. Bakit ngayon, nag-uso sa Senado ng additional MOOE kuno? Binibigay sa Pasko.
Uh-oh.
Eh, sarado ng opisina eh. Tapos ng taon. Pag Enero, meron ka ng 2.2 million for...
Ah, oh, for na your, MOOE
that's
ulit.
Right.
So why give
that's
1.6 plus 250,000 at the end of
that's
the year?
That's the point.
I see. Very
that's why
good.
Making such a big racket about it.
Okay, well, sabi ni Vice President Binay, there was a quote, kaya daw tinawag na Christmas gift kasi it was given on Christmas.
Ayan.
Oh.
Ah, siya mismo nagsabing, it's a gift. Nakalagay sa headline ng dyaryo, si Enrile mismo.
Yeah.
Enrile, colon.
It's not
gifts,
a bribe.
Not bribes. So siya mismo nagsabi, at sinasabi pa ng mga defenders niya, lambing ni Enrile. Pag naglambing tayong dalawa,
okay,
gustuhin ko man, hindi kita mabigyan ng 2 million, Karen, no matter how much I admire you as a journalist. I can't even give 2 million to my husband. At yan ang dapat lambingin ko sa lahat. Diba? Oh.
All right, we're gonna take a quick break. When we return, oh my gosh, 50 minutes is not enough for Senator Miriam Santiago. You're watching Head Start. We'll be right back. We're gonna take one quick break. All right, joining us on Hot Coffee, Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago is with us. I think Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile is watching, and he just said he's available to guest to respond to Senator Miriam Santiago.
Ay, hindi
this
lang
is
yun.
Never ending.
Ay,
but could you be soulmates in another life?
Bayaan mo ng soulmates in another life? Maybe there is no other life except this one. But ang punto dito ay ganito. Nag-guest speaker ako sa Centro Escolar University, and there, I challenged him to a debate.
Uh-oh.
The next day, the media reported, he said, no, I don't want a debate. Gusto niya magsagutan kami ng magsagutan para kaming mga palingkera. Pero ayaw niyang matapos na itong usapan na ito na magharapan kaming dalawa. Na tig-iisa lang kami. Wala nang hindi niya kasama yung mga attack dogs
all right.
niya.
But very quickly, Mama, because we don't have enough time, but Enrile said that you are chairman of two oversight committees.
So,
okay, roughly the budget of that, you're getting 25 million a year.
25 million?
Is it 25 million?
Maybe the committee.
The committee.
But not me.
Okay.
Hindi na pupunta sa chairman yan kasi lahat kayo, meron kayong mga allowances dyan sa committee na yan.
Because Senate President Enrile always mentions, in effect, how he, in effect, wants to be fair to all the senators,
really?
Even minority, that he gives them committees and increases the budget.
Hindi ganun yun. Hindi siya maging Senate President kung hindi siya nagkasundo sa head ng NP, sa head ng NPC, sa head ng LP, na lahat bigyan na lang ng committees. Kasi wala siyang partido sarili niya. The normal behavior is, when you become Senate President, it is accepted. Then you are the head of the majority. And the majority get all the committees and the minority don't get any. Sigun yan sa usapan nila. Pero itong sa kaso niya, kunwari lang yon. Nagkasundo sila para mabuo ang coalition na lahat na lang may committee.
Okay.
Kaya anong sinasabi niya?
Okay.
Panginoon siya na siyang magsabing, oh, ito, yan.
Uh-oh. Now, come 2013, there's a 99% chance you're gonna have two Enriles in the Senate.
Bakit 99%?
It's 100. Jack and JPE.
I know that, but bakit 99%?
Well, who knows? I mean, I'm not God. I mean, I don't know what's gonna happen.
Pag-survey na mataas ang anak niya, believe siya sa survey. Ngayon nag-survey na after the impeachment trial, 68% ako, number one pala ako sa publiko. Siya ay 16% at number two lang pala siya. Sabi niya, hindi daw totoo yon. Kaya he has to make up his mind.
No, okay. Now, there are two Enriles that will be in 2013. Okay, just put it to there's a high probability. Is that good?
It's just hypothetical, okay?
Okay, let's just say.
Of course not.
Why isn't it? Well, you have two Cayetanos.
Yeah.
I mean, you have two Estradas. I mean,
tinanong ko ang aking hairdresser, ha? Ano tingin mo itong mga dynasties na ito? Kasi wala pa tayong batas, eh. Kaya hindi natin mapa...
But they say it's an election. People can choose.
But the Constitution says, political dynasties shall not be allowed as may be provided by law. Eh, sinong gumagawa ng batas ni Kongreso? Kaya wala tayong political anti-political dynasty law. I filed one, but it never got beyond... It never even got to first base. Kasi natural, gusto nila lahat, ipamana nila ang mga posisyon nila sa mga anak nila, sa asawa nila, sa kirida nila, sa kapitbahay, sa katulong.
All right, if you were gonna make the family political, the family dynasty law, because I was disturbed personally that in 2013, the names that are showing up, coming in, and I've been very open about this, not on any particular candidate, are all those whose parents have already been senators, right. Fathers been president. It's almost like people are going on name recall alone.
That's right. So sabi ko sa hairdresser ko, anong titingin mo? Sabi niya, ma'am, sa mga sinasabi ng aking mga customers, sila lang bang marunong? Sila lang bang may kaya? At just to think about it as an intelligent college graduate, is that democratic that you pass on as if you were monarchical, your position to another person just because of blood ties? Can't you give other people a chance? If you are already rich after receiving all your MOOE and your Christmas gifts, anong tsansa ng tatakbo galing sa mahirap? Wala siyang ganong pera.
So what, in the dynasty, what parameters would you put very quickly? Like when one is sitting, no wife, no child? How would you do it?
In that same of agency.
Yeah, in the Senate, for example.
Dyan lang.
But they can run anywhere else.
Right.
Okay.
That would be, I think, fair.
That would be fair. Uh-oh. Okay.
So, kung gusto niyo may senador pamilya niyo, one of you has to wait until you have finished your term, then the other one can run.
Okay.
Pero hindi pwedeng lahat kayo nandoon pare-pareho.
Okay. Now, you have to forgive me for bringing this up, but Enrile has brought this up a few times that you said intelligent college graduate, and he keeps saying that you either almost flunked the bar or you flunked the bar. No, you couldn't. You almost flunked the bar.
Yeah. So anong pakialam niya?
So you're going, so because this is always what he brings up against you.
Yeah, that's personal, right?
Okay.
He's making a personal accusation against me. Anong relasyon niyan dito sa pera? Pero sasagutin ko yung tanong na
okay,
yun.
Okay, go ahead.
Maliban mamaya.
Uh-oh.
Pero una, bakit napunta na sa ganun? Personal na yan, ah. Tinawag pa niya ako ng mga ibang mga mahalay ng mga salita na lagay sa dyaryo yun, eh. Pero I'm not going to file a case. You know why? Because you're always saying, file a case against me, sue me. Kasi, there's a principle in law called the principle of exhaustion of administrative remedies. Hindi ka pwede mag-file ng kaso sa korte kung hindi ka muna gumawa ng paraan sa mga bureaucrats or bureaucratic offices that have primary jurisdiction over that matter. That's why I went to COA and said, will you please study and report on this? All right. So, nakikita mo na yung kanyang argumento is called in logic 101, argumentum ad hominem, which is absolutely
okay.
Oh, what all about right. If I say, what about you? You got body odor. Wala nang katapusan yan. Ngayon sasagutin ko, I almost flunked the bar. That's right, because I fell in love.
Really?
Yes.
No, I've never heard this. I want to hear this. Before we go to another commercial break, wait. So in a way, you are admitting that you did almost fail the bar.
Yeah.
Okay.
I never denied it. I never passed myself off as topping the
bar. That you topped the bar.
That's right.
Okay.
What I'm saying is I passed the bar.
Because people always say you're too smart, you're so intelligent, you're a constitutional expert. And this almost flunked the bar issue is holding you. You know what I mean?
That's right.
Okay.
I almost flunked the bar. Hindi naman.
Okay.
But I did not top the bar.
Okay.
Oh, ano ngayon ang reklamo niya? Bakit I did not top, tungkol sa I did not top the bar? Bakit?
You fell in love then?
No, not only that, because I wanted to go on a scholarship to Russia, which at that time was unexplored territory.
All right.
And my father said, no, the bar is more important, take it. So that was my form of rebellion against my father.
I see. You didn't study for the bar.
Well, I studied, but also I found the questions just completely unintelligible. Anong pinagtatanong nito? What is this guy thinking
okay,
of?
Okay, but very quickly, I want to go to you falling at in love before the quick break.
At meron tayong magna cum laude, ha? Sa UP College of Law. Hindi rin niya ni-top ang bar. Si Recto, I think, didn't top the bar, didn't even pass the bar. So why single me
well,
out?
Wait, Senator Recto?
No,
another person.
Claro Recto.
Oh, Claro M. Recto.
Yeah, the national hero.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. No, very quickly. So how badly...
Kung hindi ba malisyoso yung taong yun? Bakit pati yun eh, isasama niya sa debate? Ang debate dito ay tungkol sa 2 million na niregalo niya sa mga senador. Bakit nadalhin niya kung saan-saan? I'm very familiar with that because I was best debater in the UP College of Law.
Okay, now very quickly, how in love were you before the quick break? Were you really badly in love?
No, not
how
really.
How old were you then?
I was flirting with everybody, I think.
What?
Because it was my form of rebellion. It was my form of paternal rebellion. Sabi ng daddy ko, hindi ka pwedeng pumunta sa Russia. And I said, this is very rare. I'll be one of the very few Filipinos who ever stepped into Russia during the time of its totalitarian regime.
Yeah, but I mean, I'm really curious about this. I wish we had a whole other... Were you a major flirt when you were young?
No.
But you were flirting with everybody. But you were really in love, you said.
No. Asked my roommate, because she always makes it a joke. She said, itong si Miriam, bar exam time, nagdi-date.
Ah, date ka ng
every
date.
Every weekend, she would go on a date. Kaya hindi yan nag-top ng bar.
I'm curious.
That's my roommate.
Did you used to drink and smoke?
No.
Never. Were you a nerd?
Yeah.
You were a nerd?
Yeah.
But you like boys?
I like them as, you know, to keep me company. Besides, libre. Do you want to have dinner? Do you want to go to a movie? Eh, ngayon eh.
All right. Oh. Let's take a quick break. Senator Miriam Santiago and I will be right back. 2 seconds.
The daily hustle and bustle at work and of city life can take a toll on your health. And most of the time, even a high dose of vitamin C is not enough to boost your immune system. You need a multivitamin supplement that gives you maximum protection against diseases. You need Kunzase with vitamins A, C, E, and zinc that give you superior white blood cells. Kunzase for heavy-duty immunity.
Welcome back to Hot Coffee. With us is Senator Miriam Santiago. Very quickly, questions from Twitter. It's 8:54. Okay, John Pogi asks, any pickup line for Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile?
Ayoko na ng pickup lines kasi the children are picking each other up in the campuses.
They are?
Mamaya baka mag-population explosion na tayo.
Okay,
That's why I fought so hard for the RH bill.
Yes, yes.
Well, anyway, ito na lang. Advice na ngayon ako.
Kay Enrile?
Hindi. Advice na ako ngayon. I'm an advisor because I'm a mother and a grandmother.
You're amazing.
Unang advice.
So no more pickup lines in schools?
Hindi na.
Okay.
Iba na. Maternal advice. Kung meron kang tao, isang tao na mahal mo, ipaglaban mo.
I agree.
Oo. Oh. Pero kung mahal mo, sobra sa isa, paglabanin mo sila.
Where do you get these things? My God! That's a good one, though. That's the art of seduction. Okay. Are you still romantic to your husband?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay, you are?
Yeah.
So you have
I love my husband very much. We're very happily married, despite all the black propaganda.
Yeah.
And I consider him my best friend.
Yes.
In fact, we are now thinking of retirement and which one of us will go first.
The man usually does, though. I mean,
statistically.
Yeah, women live longer.
That's right.
Yeah.
So I'm always trying to get him to agree to a death compact.
A death compact?
Right.
Why?
Para mamatay kaming sabay.
How could that be? You can't plan that.
Oh, di bale. Di si Enrile na lang kaya kumbidahin ko mag-death compact.
But Enrile is so strong. Huh? I mean, I have to say, he's looking very strong.
Eh, nag-stem cell treatment. Eh.
Yeah, you don't want to do stem cell?
No.
Why not?
I don't want to live long.
You don't want to live long?
No. I think I finished my work.
You did?
Tapos ng trabaho ko dito. Kaya pupunta na ako sa International Criminal Court sa The Hague.
Okay, but very quickly and really also brought that up. When are you coming? If you leave for The Hague before 2013, then they could have put another senator. So in 2013
to 2016... Ayan, nakikialam naman si matanda sa negosyo, sa buhay ng iba.
Ano?
Pakialam niya.
No, but then he's just, I think, Senate President Enrile's concern. So it wouldn't be wasted.
Ikaw, Johnny, magbasa ka ng Rome Statute of the International Criminal Court. Abogado ka pa man din. Bakit ka nagpapa-abogado kay Senator Panfilo Lacson? Hindi yan abogado eh. Tsaka sinabi ko na sa iyo, debate tayong dalawa. Eh nakita mo lang ako sa TV ngayon, gusto mo, kasunod ka naman. Eh bakit ganun ang gusto mo? Harap-harapan tayo para makinig ng buong taong bayan ang rason mo at ang rason ko at bahala sila kung anong hatol nila. Hindi na magsiraan tayong dalawa. Sinong natutuwa doon? Ikaw?
Oo.
Ngayon,
yes.
Bakit niya makikialam sa International Criminal Court? Basahin lang niya. That's available on the internet. In the International Criminal Court, the newly elected judge has no discretion on when she shall report for work. But I was very aware that I was elected in 2010 for 6 years.
Okay.
So I wrote the presidency and said, I've been elected until 2016. I know the tradition is, pag number one kang elected judge, you get called first. But if you will allow me, I will waive that privilege. And I, in fact, would welcome it if you called me last. Because okay. I don't want my voters to be disillusioned with me. And the presidency said, yes, we grant your request on condition that still you will hold yourself ready and available at any time in case you're badly needed, urgently needed in the ICC. That's why I don't know when I will report there. The president does not know when he will report there. Because ang sistema kaiba sa Pilipinas. Kaya ikaw...
No. Okay, I'm curious. You cannot control your temper?
Huh?
No, I'm really curious about this. During the impeachment trial, I anchored it for ANC, so I was seeing you every day. Are you the kind of person you cannot control your temper at all?
I can if I want to.
If you want to?
Yeah.
But if you don't want to...
I don't.
It explodes.
Of course. Any person, that can happen to any person.
Yeah, that's because called rage, I think, though.
No, it's not called rage. It's called righteous indignation.
Okay.
Nakikita mong batas, yun ang hanap buhay mo. Ginaganyan, binabastos ng tao, tapos wala kang kakibo-kibo. For evil to triumph, it is sufficient that good men shall do nothing. Kaya kasalanan ko, nagdaldal ako. Ang gusto nila, manahimik ako at makisama. Yun ang problema. Marami silang tinatanong ngayon. Ba't hindi nyo tinanong sa akin yan noon pa? Bakit ngayon lang na... Binrim ako ang 2 million pesos.
Okay. I'm curious, before we end, who would you want to be Senate President?
I don't
honestly,
know.
Honestly.
I absolutely do not have any interest. There's a job waiting for me.
But who do you think among the senators can do it?
Maraming former Senate Presidents dyan. Si Angara, si Villar, si Drilon. Yan. At saka mga bata, pwede rin.
Pwede rin.
Oh, ngayon, ang aking lang ay ganito. Sa International Criminal Court,
okay.
Hindi ulit na halal ka, tatawagin ka na.
Okay.
Kung hindi, merong magre-retire na judge o baka retired na siya, he reached retirement age. But he will have to stay, it is his duty to stay there until he has finished all his cases.
Okay.
Kaiba sa atin.
Oo.
That's why nobody knows, even the presidency of the ICC does not know when a new judge will be called because we all have to wait until a retired judge has finished all his cases. And you cannot predict when those cases will be finished.
Okay.
That's why we don't know.
All right. Okay, on that note, please don't think I'm cutting you. It's 9 in the morning.
I know.
All right, Senator Miriam, thank you so much for coming. I hope you come back again because there's still so many other issues. Premature campaigning law, cybercrime law, you have your own law. I hope we can discuss that when you come back. Is that possible?
Pakikuha lang ng blood pressure.
All right. Okay. I hope you come back, man. Let's get started today. Just a clarification. Our executive producer, their office didn't say that JPE was available. We are saying that he is available to respond to your... Baka mag-away daw kasi kayo ulit. He is available to respond to your allegations.
Pwede rin away kung gusto niya.
Huh?
According to the Marquis of Queensberry rules, no hitting below the belt. He's been doing that to me, eh.
Okay, no
kidding. Marami rin siyang lihim, huwag.
Okay. All right, I think this is a classic. This is gonna be... Okay, this is the classic today. All right, let's Head Start. We had Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago. It's a privilege. Almost the anniversary of Head Start. I'm Karen Davila. Have a good day, everyone. And you know what? I'm going to leave you with this. See you tomorrow.